How do the strategists see it in terms of election math? Who benefits from that dynamic with at least three elected leaders with similar progressive stripes going after the same voters?
It's interesting because ideologically, it's actually very hard to separate De Leon from Carrillo and Santiago. And so I think that what strategists are looking at are things like who represents what part of the district. Wendy Carrillo's assembly district has slightly more than Miguel Santiago's. And so does that give them a benefit in terms of introducing themselves to the voters of the council? But an X factor that I think is also worth noticing is there is another contender who has been getting some buzz. Her name is Isabel Jurado. She's a tenants' rights lawyer who's not an elected official, but she has been getting the backing of what the LA sort of progressive establishment, and including De Leon's colleague, Eunices Hernandez, a council member who has come from this sort of a surging progressive movement. And so I think that it's possible that all three of those candidates get outflanked on the left by Jurado, who really distinguishes herself by not being a politician.